In this video, we'll cover two unique short-line railroads in the northwestern United States operating with first-generation EMD power. The St. Mary's River Railroad, STMA, and Columbia Basin Railroad, CBRW, employ GP9 and SD9 locomotives to operate their trains, with many of these units at or beyond their 65th year of service as of 2022. We'll begin our coverage in Idaho on the St. Mary's River Railroad. On this day, we'll follow the railroad's Plummer turn headed west to the Union Pacific Interchange, with a former Milwaukee Road GP9 providing the power for today's train. Loads of forest products from Potlatch and St. Mary's make up the train today. Crossing the long trestle over Benewah Lake, STMA's westbound Plummer turn slowly makes its way across the impressive structure on a warm July day in 2017. This is arguably the most recognizable location on the STMA, having been featured countless times in photographs from both the Milwaukee Road and St. Mary's eras. The train crosses Highway 5 as the lone GP9 struggles upgrade away from Benewah Lake. The STMA began operations following the abandonment of the Milwaukee Road's Pacific Extension in 1980, with the railroad preserving rail service on the Milwaukee's mainline between St. Mary's and Plummer, Idaho. Today, the STMA operates a tri-weekly turn to Plummer to interchange traffic with the Union Pacific, which is the railroad's only outside connection. The Union Pacific's Plummer turn departs Plummer after interchanging traffic with the St. Mary's. The train is heading back to Spokane on the former Milwaukee Road passenger main. Moving west to Washington, we'll now cover the Columbia Basin Railroad operating over former Burlington Northern trackage out of Warden, Washington. We'll head north to Wheeler, then return south to Connell, with our cameras capturing trains on CBRW's mainline. Beginning on a foggy January morning, we set up next to the Columbia Basin's operations base and locomotive servicing tracks in Warden. Two morning crews are just coming on duty, with one crew heading north to Wheeler, and the other heading south to Connell, where they will interchange freight with BNSF. Both crews will select a set of power that best suits their needs before building their respective trains. On a different day, a former Montana Rail-Link SD9 heads up the northbound turn to Wheeler, with a heavy cut of phosphate making up the train this morning. Nearing Interstate 90, the train is now climbing a steep grade for the final few miles into Wheeler. Thank you. After serving industries in the Wheeler area, the Wheeler job returns to Warden with a small train. We'll now head south from Warden towards Connell. Southbound Connell Turn puts on a great show as they work upgrade out of a sag south of Warden. monster Connell turn works south out of Bruce with five first-generation diesels leading the way. After interchanging freight with BNSF and Connell, CBRW's northbound Connell turn slowly works upgrade with a former Washington Central GP9 now in the lead. This unit is right at home on these former Northern Pacific rails, with the locomotive originally built as NP-316 in 1957. Thank you for joining us. Look for more compelling content coming soon from C Vision Productions.